A team of biologists, wets, and fishermen temporarily captured rare freshwater dolphins in Amazon this week. It was to study their health in hopes of avoiding a repeat of the deaths of hundreds of the mammals last year due to a severe drought. But that is not all. This is what they found. Take a look at this report.
These rare freshwater dolphins, known for their striking pink color, are only found in the rivers of South America. But climate change and drought are threatening the species. Now a team of scientists in Brazil are studying the Amazon River dolphin in the hopes of learning exactly how extreme conditions are changing their behavior. 2023 marked the longest drought in the Amazon rainforest's recorded history. Nearly 300 of the dolphins died, with most of them in Brazil's Lake Tefe. Researchers believe low water levels during the drought led to high temperatures not suited for the dolphins. Lake Tefe reached 102 degrees Fahrenheit last September. It's now at 86 Fahrenheit, said a geosciences researcher at the Mamoru Institute. And slow reproductive cycles make their populations especially vulnerable to threats. A team of biologists, vets, and fishermen recently caught a female dolphin in Lake Tefe to gather more information. They brought it ashore for blood tests and to insert a microchip to study the dolphin's behavior after being returned to the lake. Here's veterinarian Thais Carneiro Santos Rodriguez.
This time we're aiming to place some satellite tracking tags that will not only show us the movement of these animals during the dry season, but will also be able to measure the temperature of the water and the depth at which these animals are. So this will show us how they behave during drought and how drought and climate change can alter the normal movements of these animals.
Environmental activists have blamed the unusual conditions on climate change, which makes droughts and heat waves more likely and severe. Global warming's role in last year's Amazon drought is unclear, with other factors such as El Niño at play. Miriam Marmontel is the project's head with the Mamoru Institute of Sustainable Development. She says studying the dolphins will reveal whether the impacts were due to temperature, pollutants, or a combination of issues.
Chile's Atacama Salt Flat is sinking at a rate of 1 to 2 centimeters per year, and that is according to a study by the University of Chile. Now, this is due to lithium brine extraction. The study used satellite data collected between 2020 and 2023 to verify deformations in the Earth's crust.
It is not happening in the entire salt flat. It is happening in a specific area of the Atacama salt flat, and it coincides with the areas where the companies pump groundwater to extract lithium, or where most of their pumping or the most intense pumping occurs.
In his report, Delgado said the pumping of lithium-rich brine occurs at a faster rate than the recharge of aquifers. Now, it leads to subsidence, or the downward vertical movement of the Earth's surface. The data was obtained by SOCOM-1 satellite constellation of Argentina's National Commission for Space Studies using interferometric synthetic aperture radar. Now, Chile, the world's second largest lithium producer, extracts the lightweight metal from Atacama Salt Flat. It has one of the largest lithium reserves in the world. Native communities that ring the Atacama worry that mining may be depleting scarce freshwater and lithium-rich brine, reducing its availability for people and wildlife. Environmental authorities have charged SQM and Albemarle, the two lithium producers in Chile, with possible irregularities when it comes to brine extraction.
The area where the surface sinks between 1 or 2 centimeters per year coincides with where the water table, the level where the groundwater table is, has decreased its depth. It happens because they pump a lot of groundwater to extract lithium.